From the earliest days, Eaton has been at the forefront of innovation for circuit protection technology. But what do we mean by circuit protection, and why is it so important? For some time now, roughly two centuries, our world has become dependent on electrical power. This brings with it a level of risk from hazards such as electrical shock, arc flash, damage to equipment, and fires. Circuit protection dramatically reduces the likelihood of these incidents and helps minimize their impact. But we still have work to do. Let's start by reviewing what conditions cause these hazards to occur. These include overloads, short circuits or faults, ground faults, and arc flash. These conditions can cause overheating, equipment damage, insulation breakdown, and as mentioned, electrical fires, unfortunately. Let's look at an example. Consider a simple circuit with this piece of wire rated for 20 amps and a 20 amp circuit breaker, a type of circuit protection device. For this example, consider a lighting circuit in your home with only 3 amps of current flowing through it. This normal situation will allow the breaker and the wire to remain well within their thermal ratings. But what happens if you put too much load on that circuit and the protective device wasn't there? Say, for example, you turned on a bathroom fan and a hairdryer at the same time. In a typical home, this would overload a wire rated for 20 amps and the wire would start to overheat. If allowed to persist, the wire insulation would start to break down and a fire could start behind the walls. This is what we would call an overload condition. With circuit protection, the 20 amp wire is protected with a 20 amp protective device. The overcurrent condition will trigger the device to operate, interrupting the circuit before the wire gets hot enough to cause a fire. It's important to remember the purpose of circuit protection here is to protect the wire. Tripping a breaker every time you blow dry your hair and forgot to shut off the bathroom fan can be annoying. But upsizing the breaker to match the load instead of the wire is not the answer. A failure to remember that is the source of many house fires. Now let's look at a short circuit or fault example where an unintended connection is made between two conductors. The current at the fault location will increase significantly because the energy dissipated in the wire is proportional to the square of the increase in current. The wire temperature rises more rapidly than during the previous overload condition. To prevent a fire from happening during a short circuit condition, circuit protection has to be adaptive and ready to trip faster. In comparison, during an overload condition, a breaker or fuse may take 2 to 3 minutes to clear the circuit. During a short circuit, the fault may be cleared in milliseconds. The protective device must de-energize the circuit fast enough before the wire reaches dangerous temperatures. Other special circumstances occur when you have ground faults and arc faults. A ground fault would be when there is an unintended connection between a conductor and the ground conductor or surface. Ground fault circuit interrupters, or GFCIs, detect the difference in current going out from the breaker versus the current returning to the panel. The device trips the circuit when the difference exceeds an established threshold. For example, 5 milliamps for people protection and 30 milliamps for equipment protection. An arcing fault can occur with loose connections or unintentional breaks in conductors. Arc fault circuit interrupters, or AFCIs, trip the circuit when arcing faults are detected. An arc flash is a high energy discharge of electricity between two or more conductors or ground. This creates an explosive event which can cause significant damage to equipment and harm to people. But real power systems are more than a single protective device. Even your home has dozens of circuit protective devices. A hospital or a data center could have thousands with devices ranging from just a few amps to thousands of amps operating at tens of thousands of volts. In addition to the protection of wires and equipment on the circuit, protective devices are coordinated so that the device closest to the fault will clear first, minimizing the outage to the smallest portion of the electrical system. This is an example of a protective device on the utility side of our service here at the Experience Center. This fuse cutout will protect the underground cable feeding our building from overloads and short circuits. In a large facility, medium voltage switchgear contains large vacuum circuit breakers like this 15 kV, 3000 amp breaker with enough capacity to feed 25,000 homes. These breakers interrupt large load and fault currents in a small space with Eaton's vacuum bottle technology. Medium voltage breakers use protective relays to tell the breaker when to trip based on settings to optimize coordination. This low voltage assembly contains power circuit breakers with integral chip units, similar to the relays on medium voltage breakers. For very high short circuit situations, fuses are coupled with these breakers to provide the fastest clearing time for any fault current level. For circuit protection on a switchboard like this, molded case circuit breakers and fuses are used. Electronic chip units and MCCBs provide short circuit, ground fault, arc fault, and overload protection, as well as add communications and metering capabilities. As with protective relays, these devices monitor power flow and provide specialized diagnostics for fault analysis. Generally speaking, power circuit breakers are found in low voltage and medium voltage switchgear, while molded case circuit breakers are found in panel boards and switchboards. Insulated case circuit breakers are another option that are typically found in switchboards. Busway with bus plugs are like a distributed panel board or switchboard where fuses or breakers are used to step down the ampacity rating of a circuit while providing overload and fault protection. For example, this 400 amp bus transitions to a 30 amp circuit at this bus plug, reducing materials and installation costs while feeding downstream devices. Panel boards are common equipment in all facilities and may contain fuses, such as this Bossman Quick Spec panel board, or may contain bolt-on breakers, such as this Powerline Expert panel board. A load center, similar to what you have in your home, uses lower cost, plug-on miniature circuit breakers suitable for lower ampacities. AFCI and GFCI are special purpose breakers mandated by the National Electric Code to further enhance protection and safety. Receptacles, which typically do not include overcurrent protection, can include AFCI and GFCI protection, as well as remote control switching. For control panels, fuses and supplemental protectors are used throughout to allow the use of smaller wire sizes, optimizing cost and flexibility. While this equipment may be familiar to you, there's much more to the story of circuit protection than just the protective devices. Other critical issues to consider include coordination, device settings, and ratings of protective devices. For example, the interrupting rating of a protective device is the maximum fault current that it can interrupt. The withstand rating is the amount of current that a device can survive while another protective device in the current path clears the fault. The short time rating of a device is the amount of current that the device can withstand for a defined period of time. For example, half a second after which it is expected to then clear the full fault current. Installations including solar and microgrid with battery storage add complicating factors when switching direct current. Without zero crossings, which occur naturally on AC circuits, DC circuits are more difficult to break. Eaton has many solutions for DC current interruption at very high power levels, and we continue to push the state of the art with these solutions. Motor starting and transformer inrush present other conditions to consider when selecting and setting a protective device. During either of these conditions, you do not want the protective device to nuisance trip. Normally, that involves adding intentional delay to the protective settings, but that has consequences like the protective device may not operate when an actual fault or overload occurs. Motor control centers include multiple circuit protectors such as contactors with overloads and fuses or circuit breakers to prevent overloads and short circuits. Finally, arc flash analysis adds another level of complexity to the optimization calculations for system protection. There are many solutions to choose from to enhance arc flash safety. Check out this video for more details. Power systems protection technology is constantly evolving. For more than 100 years, Eaton has been in the business of circuit protection with significant products and services to help you design and operate your power system. At one of the Power Systems Experience Centers, we can show you some of our latest innovations in circuit protection, as well as our long-standing solutions that have been protecting power systems for many years. Contact us or your local Eaton representative to schedule a visit to one of our Power Systems Experience Centers today.